Adobe's added a new feature which can automatically detect and remove people, power lines, different distractions in photos. But there's a couple of things you need to be aware of to get the most out of this. Let's dive into it right now. So this is a new feature built into the remove tool, which can get rid of people automatically and power lines. But there's a couple of gotchas you need to be aware of. First of all, let's see how it works. Now this is only currently available in the beta version of Photoshop. So I'll link to a video on how to download that. So let's go to the remove tool, and you'll notice that we have the option to find distractions. What we want to do though is create a new layer, so it'll be generated on a new layer, and make sure you turn on sample all layers or it won't work. So under distractions, look at this, we have two options here. We have people, wires, and cables. Let's try people, and then what it does is it highlights all the people. Now there's further options I'll show you in a second, but let's just apply this. And look at that, that did a great job. Now, if you want to get rid of things like this, just with the remove tool, you can just paint over that. Boom, it's gone. Right, let's have a look at these wires. Let's create another new layer. And then under find distractions, we're going to choose wires and cables. Now, this one doesn't give you the option to edit it. It's just going to remove them. And look at that. That did a pretty good job. If we look at this, here we go, before. After. All right, let's dig into the nitty-gritty. And if you're getting any value out of this video, hit that subscribe button, turn on notifications, you won't miss any of my videos. All right, let's go find distractions, and we'll just quickly do people. And then we're going to just remove it. Okay, there's some problems here. One, notice the bicycle's still there, but the person is gone. Number two, part of that car is missing. And then maybe we wanted to keep this lady in the foreground. So let me show you exactly how we would get around that. All right, let's create a new layer. Make sure sample all layers is on. And then under find distractions, we're going to choose people. All right, selected all the people, but we don't want to remove her. And maybe we want to remove some of these other people. So what we're going to do is, first of all, we're going to change the color because the magenta is hard to see. Let's grab something like a chartreuse. Much easier to see there. And then we're going to minus. So notice this is the plus. I can choose the minus or just hold the Alt or the Option key and that will remove. So I just hold that down as I'm painting. I prefer to not have to go up and choose new tools if I don't need to. Now, if I want to add anything, all I need to do is just release and we can add. So just painting there. Notice that goes back to the plus. Now something to be aware of, this bike here. The bike would actually be kept and the person would be gone if I was to not touch that up. So I'm going to hit the left bracket key, make this a little smaller. Make sure we get the wheel. And I want to make sure that doesn't get included. So I'm holding the Alt or the Option key. Same with the edge of that car. So you've got to watch it on the edges. It's not too great at that at the moment. Now, we can keep this person there or we can remove him. Let's remove this person. All right. And at this point here, we're going to apply it. And boom. So as you can see, it did a much better job when we give it a little bit of guidance. Let's look at something of the wires. So we're going to create a new layer here. Now, one of the things about this, it will remove the wires, but it won't remove the other attachments. Let me show you what I mean. So if we choose find distraction, we choose wires and cables. Notice it got rid of the wires, but now we've got these lights floating in midair. All right, so as you can see there, that gets a little interesting. But once again, this could be useful. You know, if you're doing special effects, maybe you're hanging something on some string or something like that. You could easily get rid of the string, you know, like a really Dracula movie or something. I don't know. So drop a comment underneath and let me know if you learned anything new in this video. By the way, if you want to learn more about the remove tool, check out this video right here. If you're new, welcome to the cafe. Hit the subscribe button, turn on notifications. You won't miss any of my tutorials. And until next time, I'll see you at the cafe.